All right, everybody. Welcome back to the laboratory. This is your Dr. Cranky with another episode of some quick airbrushing ideas. We're going to begin with just some basic templates in my collection, and your collection will grow too as your interest in airbrushing different things grows. As I said before, I've never worried about being able to freehand because that's not my approach to airbrushing. If I wanted to be an illustrator or an artist, I would definitely try it, but I don't have that kind of background or training. So, you know, we begin with simple things that you could purchase and then utilize on your models. You know, this is a Craig Fraser template. All right. And I'll just show you quickly what a template does. So much faster than if you actually try to do it freehand, which would be insane. But anyway, let me crank up the air and show you quickly here. Once again, we warm up a little bit. You put the template. You always want to make sure that you either tape the template down or hold it. Okay. Normally, I wear latex gloves, and that's it. And so I'm going to just spray a little bit here, just to give you an idea of what happens. Eventually you'll get the hang of it, and it'll be second nature to you. All right, so you use the air to dry the paint, because as you can see, it's probably grainy, and that means that it's still wet on the template. You want to be careful not to move the template, and you also want to be careful when you pull it back away from your paint job, so not to smear it. So there you go. All of a sudden, you've got these weird, crazy flames. So let's say you're doing racing stripes on the car, but you want some cool graphics. Here we go. Well, this time around, let me show you another template. That way we vary it up. Let's say you want, this is a skull template. Again, a Craig Fraser line. All right. So let's say you want some weird skulls. So you just, have fun with them. Make sure that you get enough paint all around. There, bingo, you got instant skulls. All right, so you could do this as much as you want, and knock yourself out. But it's a heck of a lot of fun, and just playing around with them. After you're done with the template, you could dip it in a little bit of Windex if you're using acrylics, or a little bit of airbrush cleaner if you are using urethanes or any other line of paint like enamels, and leave it soaking overnight and it'll come off. So I mean, you could have all kinds of, and I do. Dr. Cranky loves templates for this reason, because you could set up a basic, and then of course once you start getting a little braver, then you could do all kinds of freehand stuff that eventually will come natural, maybe some smoke coming out of the eyes, or you could finish I couldn't hold my hand steady enough to be able to draw, but you can fog around it. You could do all kinds of neat stuff with candies. I mean, the world is totally open when it comes to airbrushing and templates. So have fun and knock yourself out. Practice. You'll thank me later for it. But it's something that you will really and truly love, and it'll come natural. 3-4 weeks later, you'll be so happy with this thing that nobody will be able to take it away from you. All right. So have fun and continue airbrushing and learning. Thank you.